complete mediation actually comes about, or we have that, because of one other thing the operating system does. So at user level, we have what we call virtual resources. We don't have physical resources. There is no way for user code to actually name or be able to target a physical resource or ask for a physical resource. There you have only virtual resources, and the operating system actually gives you an API on how those virtual resources can be used. An example of this is that for storing persistent data, we have a file abstraction, or a virtual resource for storing persistent data is a file. So you don't access a disk block. The operating system does disk I/O and schedules requests to read blocks and services interrupts and things like that. It can interact with the disk controller through those privilege instructions we were talking about, but you cannot from user space. You can only ask for access to files, either opening them or reading them or writing them and things like that. So at the user level, we don't understand. Now, we don't have ways of directly talking to the disk controller, the low-level hardware functions that the operating system has access to. We only have these virtual resources. As a result of that, remember, virtual resources are what the name says. They are not the real resources. They have to be implemented using physical resource. A file has to be implemented with a bunch of disk blocks, okay, where the file data is stored. So the virtual resource has to be translated to physical handles or resources, for example, buffers where file data is stored and things like that. And this translation is done from virtual to physical implementation is done by the operating system. If you want to access a disk block or a page of memory, you have to start with either a file descriptor, or you start with a logical address we're talking about, or a virtual address. And the translation from virtual to physical is the first step before you can get to the physical. Only the operating system knows how to do that, or has the metadata, or has the control information that can be used for this translation. So this level of sort of indirection that we add, where you have one kind of namespace, and the underlying resources have a different namespace, and the translation can only be done by the physical, by the operating system or the trusted computing base. Well, that helps you get complete mediation, because you first need to go have the translation done. Okay, then you have to go to the trusted computing base. So the complete mediation gets implemented right then and there, because you're coming to it and asking for a physical resource. So it could be the reference monitor. It can check at that point that whatever that you're asking for, do you have access to it?